how to make friends in Paris. Hop on a plane and go back to your home country. Hey besties, welcome or welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, hi, hello, my name is Tiana. I am an American living in Paris and I make videos all about my experience as an expat in France, my life in Paris, student life in Paris, travel tips, travel vlogs, things like that. So if that's something that interests you, stick around for some of the videos I have coming up in the future. Today we are going to be talking all about how to make friends in France, because I've gotten this question so many times from so many people on Instagram, in my YouTube comments, in person, friends from back home who are like,
how did you meet people if you moved there by yourself and didn't know anybody?
And I also was searching for videos like this when I was planning to move to France, because like I said, I didn't know anyone and I was freaking out about how to meet people, how I would make friends. So I thought I would make this video and give you guys some tips and tricks that you could use if you are moving to France or really any country and you don't know anyone and you're worried about making friends. This video is for you. So as most of you guys know, I've mentioned in a previous video, I was living in the south of France for a year, but I recently moved back to Paris a month ago. So even though I lived here before for a year and I know the area pretty well, and I do have my old au pair host family who lives here, so I have some kind of support system, I feel like I am kind of starting from the beginning, starting all over again, because a lot of the friends that I had here were au pairs like me, and most of them went back home to the States, or they got jobs and moved to other parts of France or other parts of Europe. So I do really feel like I am kind of starting from scratch and starting from the beginning. So I just wanted to say that I feel you guys, I see you, I resonate with you, okay? We're in the same boat. I am trying to make friends as well, but I have faith. I made friends when I first moved to Paris. I made friends when I moved to the south of France, and I know that I will make friends again here in Paris now that I'm back. So if I can do it in three different cities, I know that you guys can do it as well. Before we get started, if this topic interests you and you like to see more videos like this, go ahead and hit that like button down below. Hit the subscribe button. It really helps get the YouTube algorithm to like me and push my video to be seen by more people. I'm so close to hitting 1,000 subscribers and getting monetized, so I would really, really appreciate your guys' help in getting the YouTube gods to like me and to be in my favor. The first method I have for how to make friends in France: social media is your best friend. Let's talk about Facebook groups, okay? I know Facebook is kind of dying. Nobody really in my generation uses it anymore. I know people prefer Instagram and TikTok and Twitter and all of that. But when it comes to groups, Facebook groups are extremely, extremely helpful when it comes to meeting people in a new city or a new area. There are literally hundreds of Facebook groups for meeting people in France. There's groups like Americans in Paris, expats in Paris, English speakers on the Riviera, which is for people living in the south of France, and I talked about that in my last video, everything you need to know about living in Nice. So there is one specifically for Nice. There's one for any city. Literally all you have to do is type expats in my city or Americans in my city, British people in Paris, British people in Lyon. Like, there's so many Facebook groups, you guys. International students in Paris, au pairs in Paris. Like, there's so many different Facebook groups for meeting people. You can search by your nationality, so like Americans in Paris or expats in Paris. You can search by interest, so like fitness groups in Paris or girls who like knitting in Paris. Like, there's literally so many groups, you guys. Next, we have Bumble. So most of you guys know Bumble is a dating app similar to Hinge and Tinder and all of those, but there's also actually a BFF feature on Bumble that you can use just to meet friends. So you have the dating side of the app, of course we know, and then you have the BFF side, so you can swipe through potential friends, and if you guys read their profile, if you have the same interests, you can swipe right, and if you guys match, you can set up a time to hang out. And literally, like, it's that simple. That's actually how I met a few of my friends in Nice. So one of my good friend Sabrina, that I hung out with most of the time I was in Nice, I met her on Bumble BFF, and then she introduced me to her friends that she met, some of them that she met on Bumble, some of them that she knew from growing up, and it just kind of spiraled. So that's a really good way to meet people as well, because once you make one friend, they introduce you to their friends, and then you meet their friends, and it really just spirals from there. Next, we have Instagram. So this is also a really good way to meet people as well. You can search through related hashtags such as Hashtag Americans in Paris. Hashtag expats in France. Hashtag literally whatever you can think of, and just scroll through the accounts, look at people's photos, go through their profiles, stalk them a little bit, like see if they post similar things to you, if you think you'd have the same interests as them, like feel free to give them a follow, like slide in the DMs, you guys, send them a nice message and see what happens. Honestly, just see what happens, you know, what's the worst that can happen? Sometimes you just have to shoot your friendship shot, and most of the time it works. The last one for social media is actually YouTube. So not many people think of this, but there are so many YouTubers and content creators living in France, especially in Paris, that are documenting their lives online. You guys obviously like to watch YouTube videos, as do I, as does pretty much everyone else. So if you happen to come across a video of a content creator that's living in France or in Paris or literally in any city that you're moving to, and you have similar interests, you think they're interesting, you think they're cool, leave a like. Leave a comment, send them a message on social media, introduce yourself, start a conversation. It can seem a little bit scary, but I promise you, just a little message can go a long way. I've met so many people in Nice who have actually reached out to me from Instagram, and people living in Paris now who have watched my videos and they're like, oh, I see your videos, I'm moving to Paris too. Like, let's hang out sometime. And honestly, like, I love that. Reach out to some content creators that you find living in Paris. The next one is gonna scare a lot of people. A lot of people will be scared here, but sometimes you have to make the first move. There will be people who want to talk to you or want to initiate conversation, but don't know how to. So sometimes you just have to take the initiative. So for the people that you kind of know or that you've met before, but you don't really know very well. So for example, like if you're a student and you maybe you have someone in your class that you've like seen before and you guys know that you're in the same class but you've never had a conversation and you're not like friends, you wouldn't hang out or anything, you gotta go up to them, girl or guy, bestie, you gotta go up to them. Make your move. Invite them to a coffee or to a cafe. Invite them to study with you after class if you're a student. This is a good one. If you're an au pair or a nanny here in France and you meet someone else who's also an au pair or a nanny, invite them to have a play date with you. You bring your host kids, they bring their host kids, you guys meet at a park or whatever, you can have a picnic, the kids can play together, you guys can hang out together. This is such a good option. I did this so many times and it's so nice because you as the au pair get kind of a break from the kids because they're entertaining themselves and the kids are content, they're playing with other kids, so they're happy, they're not worried, you're happy, you're chilling, you're making new friends. Perfect scenario. And then for people that you don't know at all, like complete strangers, this can be a little bit trickier, but there are still some techniques that you can use to kind of start a conversation and break the ice a little bit. It is generally a little difficult to speak to strangers in France, especially in Paris, because everyone's kind of like closed off, they don't speak to strangers, but I think it can be a little bit easier if you find someone who's an English speaker or another foreigner. In that case, here's an example. So say you're outside or say you're on the metro and you hear someone next to you speaking English. This could be an opportunity to spark a conversation. I've done this so many times where I'm like, you know, minding my own business in my own little world. I hear someone speaking English and immediately I'm like, I know that accent. They're from Canada or they're American or they're like, you know, instantly like, you know, and you're like, you resonate with this person because they speak your native language. And when you're in a country where you don't hear your native language very often, you miss that. So the instant that you hear someone that speaks the same language as you, it's instantly like kind of a connection in a sense. So I've used this so many times and just been like, oh, where are you from? Like, are you from Canada? Are you American? And then that's easy in, just introduce yourself from there. Or if you see someone with a cute outfit or nice jewelry, you can use that, give her a compliment, start a conversation. My bestie Tyla did this with a girl that she saw here while she was living in Paris, and then they ended up starting a conversation, being friends, and then she introduced the girl to me and we became friends. So I'm like, it's so easy. Honestly, I think for girls maybe this might be a little bit easier, but honestly you would be surprised at how far just a simple compliment goes with people. People love to talk about themselves, so just hype them up, give them compliments, make them feel good about themselves, and honestly, like, why would they not want to be your friend? And speaking of complimenting pretty jewelry, I am so excited to share with you guys that we have our first YouTube video sponsor. I just want to take a second to say thank you so much to the sponsor of today's video, Ana Luisa. Ana Luisa is an everyday jewelry brand based in New York City that specializes in making sustainable luxury jewelry at high quality but affordable prices. All the materials that are used in their jewelry pieces are ethically sourced, including the gold, which is 100% recycled and carbon neutral. Even the diamond jewelry pieces that you can find on their site are completely traceable and ethical because they actually use only lab-grown diamonds in their jewelry pieces. As you guys know, I'm a student living on a small budget in one of the most expensive cities in the world, so I don't have a ton of money to be spending on jewelry. And when I do decide to treat myself and spend some money on jewelry, it's really important to me that I find jewelry that's gonna last a long time and not gonna turn green or break after just one wear. But even though I'm a student and I don't have a lot of money to spend, I do also like to be kind of bougie on a budget and buy things that are high quality and low cost, but still look very luxe and very designer, very chic, and make me look expensive and feel good. Ana Luisa was kind enough to send me these jewelry pieces. Honestly, I love them so much. I wore these earrings out a few days ago around Paris. I got brunch with a friend. We walked around the city and just wanted to take some pictures around the city, and they looked so cute. I got such cute pictures. I got so many compliments on my jewelry, you guys. I love these pieces so much. I would 100% order from Ana Luisa, and I plan to do so in the future. Another thing I love about them is they make their jewelry in small batches, so they're not always gonna have the same pieces on the site. So it kind of gives you that boutique exclusivity kind of feel because there's not tons of amounts of the same piece, so you're not really gonna see everybody walking around with the same jewelry that you have on. Their pieces are so dainty and so elegant. They're always coming out with new pieces, so definitely go check them out. I have no doubts that you can find something that you love and that fits your style. Head on over to shop.analuisa.com/TianaMarie to check out their collection and use code TianaMarie10 at checkout to get 10% off of your first order. Thanks again, Ana Luisa, for sending me these beautiful pieces and sponsoring today's video. The next piece of advice I have for making friends here in France, especially if you want to meet actual French friends and not just other expats and English speakers, is to try to learn the language. I know it can be difficult, y'all. Trust me, I've been here 2 years, still not fluent. I still don't feel comfortable saying that I even speak French, but honestly, it's imperative to learn the language if you really want to make friends here, especially if you want to assimilate and make friends who are locals, actual French people. Find language partners. You can check Facebook groups. There's so many people posting about how they're studying French and they want someone to study with. That's the perfect opportunity to, one, make a new friend. Hello, that's the whole objective of this video. But two, practice your French. Practice studying with someone. Practice speaking. You can also enroll in a language class. There are so many language classes, especially in Paris. Next, it's important to learn the culture and the rules and etiquette of France. So learn what to do, what not to do, learn about what's taboo to talk about, what people don't really talk about, and what people feel comfortable talking about and are open with. Because a lot of the things in America that we were taught kind of to be hush-hush about and to not really talk about, French people are very open and they don't mind talking about it, and it's not seen as weird. So definitely learn that. If you haven't seen my French Culture Shocks video, definitely go watch that to see some of the nuances and kind of shocks that I found when I moved to France. Hopefully you can learn a little bit and not be as taken aback as I was. Honestly, it can be a little difficult making friends with French people in the beginning. They're generally a little more closed off and not as friendly as other people, like definitely not as friendly as Americans and other groups of people. I saw a TikTok recently that was like, how to make friends in Paris. First, take the metro. You can take any of the metro lines. Take the metro to Châtelet station in the center of the city. Then you're gonna get on the RER B and you're gonna head north to the north of Paris to Charles de Gaulle. And then you're gonna hop on a plane and go back to your home country. Obviously, that's a dramatized scenario and it's definitely not impossible to make friends as a foreigner living in France, but it does take some effort on your part. Get involved in local activities. There are so many groups around the city for you to join. There's meetup groups, there's volunteer groups. You can sign up for activities around the city. So like I said before, there's like groups on Facebook for runners in Paris or girls who like to thrift. Like, there's literally groups for everything. So try to find some activities around the city that you can join in on. And that's a really good way to meet people as well. Embrace your differences. Teach people about you. As much as you feel like an outsider and like you don't belong in the place that you're in, people will be interested to learn about you as well and learn about where you're from and your culture and your perspective on things. So take advantage of that. Take advantage of being a foreigner and having a different perspective on things and not being the same as everyone else. Use that as an excuse to meet people and to exchange ideas. Also, don't get discouraged if you don't make friends right away. It's normal, of course. Making friends as an adult is so much harder than it was when we were younger or even like in university. When everyone has common interests and lives in the same town and is doing the same things, it's so much easier to make friends. But when you're an adult and you're working or maybe you're going to school and, you know, everyone kind of has their own life, it's really a little bit harder to connect with people. So you really do have to take initiative and kind of go out of your way and take some steps to make friends. The most important thing is to just be yourself, step out of your comfort zone. Sometimes you have to do things that make you a little bit uncomfortable, but I'm telling you, that's when the best things happen. Do things you wouldn't normally do, step out of your comfort zone, take some initiative. Those efforts will pay off in the end and you will get exactly what you want. So those are the basics that you need to know to make friends here in France. I promise you guys, as long as you just be yourself, follow some of these tips, put yourself out there, take initiative, I promise you will have the best time here. You will have no problem making many, many friends from all over the country, just like I did. Thank you again to today's video sponsor, Ana Luisa. Don't forget to check out their collection at shop.analuisa.com/Tiana Marie and use code Tiana Marie 10 for 10% off of your first purchase. Love you guys so much. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I will see you next week. Bye.